Hello everyone. So I hope now everybody is ready with your container, glass container covered with an airtight lid that is filled with your rock salt powder and two big rocks of rock salt. And that is placed under sunlight for whole day to neutralize the energies which were attracted by the rock when it was in shop or you brought it at home or anywhere it could be. So you have neutralized the energies and this is placed under your cupboard or almira somewhere where it is not attracted by anyone else's energies. So I will be telling you here the first step, which is really important, and I will ask everybody who is going to perform this activity now to, you know, follow each and everything properly as per the, you know, instructions I am telling you, because this is something like I have tested on many people also. So those people who are not doing properly this step, that is not helping them out in the coming spells, because in this video or in this session we are just blessing our salt. We are asking the gods and goddesses to help you in blessing your salt, so that whenever you are performing some ritual in coming days or as per your requirement, so it will help you as the magical ingredient, and it will help you to attract your desires. It will help you to attract lot of abundance and good luck around you. So if this process basically is not you are not doing it with full process, so it will not help you, because the ingredient which we are using is itself not sufficient to help you, so you are not going to achieve success in coming spells. Okay, so this is something which you have to do now. First thing is make sure those people who are not ready with their content, so first they have to do this sunlight thing as a mandatory part, right? Because this is something which you need to do for neutralizing your salt. Okay, so once it is done, now what you will do is take a bath. Like, for example, you are decided to start doing this activity tomorrow, so make sure today night you will not have any kind of junk food or any, you know, spicy food or from outside. Why? Because when you are blessing your salt, your soul should be light, right? You should feel a bit active. You should not be lazy at all, because we are dealing with the sun's energy here, okay? And the natural energies which are around us, if our body is fatigued and we are not able to, we are just performing the ritual as it is said, so it will not help you, because those people who are already into the mystical fields, they know if they are performing some spells as a duty or as like they have started and they have to complete it, those spells and those rituals are not helping them. Why? Because you should do these things with your soul, not by your body. So if your soul is light, if your soul is fresh and you are doing it, so it will be helpful for you to manifest your desires. Okay, so take a light food. I would prefer you guys to have, you know, a very light food like khichdi and moong dal or like anything, but it should be light. Simple sandwiches. So make sure like you are taking the light food in the dinner, and next day you are having at least 8 hours of sleep, so that you don't have any sort of stress around you. Fine, so you are fresh tomorrow morning. What you have to do is you are going for take bath, and one more thing I forgot is before going to sleep, what you have to do is just put 2 tablespoons of rock salt into your water bucket and then have bath and go for sleep. Why? Because if you will do this and you are going for sleep, you will have a sound sleep and you won't have any restlessness around you. So tomorrow morning again you have to do that. You'll go for having bath. And one more thing, those people who have a lot of responsibilities to handle, do one thing, do everything, and before this is you have to do, before you decide to perform your activity, just go and have a shower. Go and have a shower with 2 tablespoons of rock salt, simple rock salt. That salt you don't have to put from your container, the simple rock salt will do. So just have a bath, and what you do, and you know, wear some loose clothes. You will feel that should be clean, properly washed, and you are just wearing it so that you are feeling comfortable enough. Okay, there should not be any kind of irritation when you are performing this activity. I mean, you are wearing some shorts or jeans or something and it is little bit, you know, tight, or you have to, you know, little bit uncomfortableness, that should not happen. So just wear as much possible loose clothes, okay, and that should be clean enough. So what you have to do after that is you had shower, you are like prepared with the clean clothes and everything, just go in some room where nobody can disturb you. If you have kids in your home, so make sure if they are having nap and they are studying and they are gone for, you know, play to play and somewhere. So if they are not at home, do that, because you can't stop kids to come and disturb you, right? It doesn't matter you are doing this particular ritual in your bedroom, in your dining room, in your you know, a living room, whatever it is, that doesn't matter. But that room should be sacred enough, that room should be like quiet enough. So what you have to do is take a little table, which I have mentioned you should have. So this is something like, you should not have the corner where you know this is not something that you have to put the setup for whole 9 days, 11 days or 21 days. No, it's not like that. You just need it for few hours or few minutes, I can say. So what you will do is just take a flat surface, that could be anything, a storage box like on top of that, or the, you know, space doesn't matter. So you should have the flat surface, and on the flat surface you just clean it. If you have the white cloth with you, so just cover it with the white cloth. If you don't have white cloth, then also it doesn't matter, like just clean it and perform your ritual on that, fine. So if you have white cloth, you have covered it with the white cloth. Now take your container and place it on that center of that table, fine. So you are placing it on center of that table. So anything like other should not be placed on that particular table, only your container is there till now. So what you will do now is you are placing your container here and remove the lid on top of it, fine. Take one white candle and place it near to it, or maybe in front of, just front of it. So it depends how much space you have on your table, fine. You are placing it near to it. Now what you have to do is just close your eyes and have deep breath, okay. Take 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as per your own wish, until and unless you don't feel that you are inhaling and the air is directly hitting your stomach, you should not stop, fine. Just calm yourself as much as you can, by any method just calm yourself, okay. You have done it. Now what you have to do is just see the salt for at least 5 minutes is enough. So just stare at it and see like what color the salt is. So it is a rock salt, the raw rock salt. So it is not I would say it is not like the refined salt, fine. So you won't see that the color is actually the bright white. So it should be the dull white as the rock salt is. So you will just stare at the salt and keep staring, fine, with the good eyes. Now you will see that you will slowly observing that the salt color is glowing little bit, like the first instance you looked at it, that was not that glowing white, but slowly as you are gazing at it, so the color is getting bright. So just keep watching at it, just keep staring, and you will see that it is now the glowing white. You will feel that the glow is really increasing when you are gazing at it, fine. So just stop doing that, and after that what you have to do is, I made a note to tell you, after that what you have to do is take the white candle on, fine. Just light the white candle, and now whatever god you are following, I mean it's up to you in which god you have beliefs, so just whatever prayer you are doing on the daily basis, close your eyes and say that prayer, fine. And do like whatever daily prayers you are doing, and you feel that okay, this particular god helps me a lot, and I wish like either it's Lord Ganesha, Lord Shiva, fine, anybody, it could be any goddess also. So just remind them and say, basically invite them to come here and help you in blessing your salt, fine. Do this till them, like there should not be any specific time that you have to call them for 3 times or 5 times. No, it's up to you. So just call them, and if you feel that now it's enough, and I call them and they are here, now what you have to do is just request them to bless your salt, fine, and say this prayer. This prayer basically I just took it from a book, so that was related to some affirmations, a book related to affirmations. So I took that book, I took that affirmation, and those people who are not having beliefs in God and who are not Hindu, and they can also like say this affirmation, fine. So the affirmation is, Father who are in heaven, how holy and great is your name, may your kingdom come, may your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, give me this day everything that is required for me this day, so that I may live my life to its highest intentions and purpose. Purify and bless this salt and allow me immense power from you to work for me, bringing fulfillment to my desires, wants and needs, so may it be. Fine. So this is the affirmation. Even though you are calling your gods and inviting them and asking them to bless your salt, you can also say these affirmations 3 times or 5 times. That is up to you. Fine. So they say this after like you light the candle, and now sit there and gaze at the salt and feel that like you invited the god and you said these affirmation. Feel that on the top of your head, I mean from the sky, a beam of white light is coming, and that is hitting, I mean this is the container, let's say, and that is hitting to the light, and the container which is having the salt, that is emitting a white light around the container. I mean, have you seen the full moon always emit the rays around the moon surface? Fine. So in the same way, your salt is emitting the white rays. Most of the people who are working with crystals, who are already into the healings, they may observe that the ray is already emitting and they are bringing some light in the room, because they may are wearing moldavite and, you know, amethyst and clear quartz, so that will help. And those people who are, this is the process which I am telling on the normal basis, those people who are having crystals with them, so I would suggest you guys to put your salt container and place the candle just in front of the container. And now what you have to do is place one selenite crystal, and place one side is the selenite crystal and one side is clear quartz. How I blessed my salt is, I placed, like this is my white candle, I placed this selenite tower on the right side, and this is my clear quartz wand on the left side. This should be like this. In between you have white candle and you are placing it like that. Even though if you don't have the tower, why I use tower and wand, because they are really good in emitting the energies. So that's why I placed it here. Selenite is basically the negativity cutter. It is not the negativity remover, it is the negativity cutter. So whatever negativity is coming like in the surrounding of selenite, it is just destroying it. So that's why I decided to place selenite. And clear quartz is really good in, you know, balancing your energies around you, and magnify the energy for all the crystals around it. So I placed the selenite and I placed the clear quartz, so it's just magnified all the energies of selenite, so that all the negativity around around the salt is like completely cut off, and now your salt is completely pure and blessed by your god. So you are sitting there for 5 to 10 minutes as per your own wish. Just feel that it is emitting the rays and you are getting all the blessings from top of it. So it is not the, I mean, you won't feel that it is directly, like continuously you are sitting there and the light is coming. Imagine it as you feel, and after that you can like go anywhere. But let the candle burn completely and place the setup there for at least 2 hours. So you are placing it for 2 hours. After that, all the residuals which you have in candle, just take it and throw it off, and you can just bury it under the soil, or place, like keep it in the running water as per your own beliefs, but I prefer it to throw it off, okay, out of your house. So now your salt is ready. It is blessed with all the energies, all the blessings of your god. So just take this container, cover it with the lid and place it under your cupboard or almira, somewhere where it should not be seen by anyone and it should not be split off, okay. This thing you have to like make sure that whenever you are just covering it again, so it should not be split off, because split off salt is considered it is not considered as a good omen. Fine. So this is the process which you have to do to bless your salt. I will request you all and recommend you all guys to do this activity when you are completely fresh by your mind, because if you are not fresh, if you have stress and if you have a lot of things coming in your mind, you are tired, you will not be able to imagine all those energies, you will not be able to work with it by your heart and by your soul, because you will complete the process for only sake of doing it, okay. So don't do this, and trust me, those people who will observe the rays which is emitting from the jar, and they will, like those people who will actually observe that it is emitting the light into the room, in the dark room, okay. So for them, this salt will really really help them to achieve all their goals in the coming spells which I'm going to share. Okay, so these are the things which I decided to work with on today's. Yeah, so just prepare your salt, and tomorrow I will be sharing other video. I will share all the videos for the spells. I'll make sure like all the spells are covered here which I have written, and I will cover the, you know, different properties also. So I decided recently to cover all the little activities which I am doing since years for the salt, so that those people who are not aware of the salt properties and who are not using rock salt in their day-to-day life, they can use it as a beneficial tool. Okay, so just do this and make sure you are not just keeping the seeing the video and keeping it aside, because if you will work like together with me, so it will be really helpful for you as well, because I will be able to help you for clearing your doubts, and a good rhythm basically is maintained. We are working all together on the same times, right? So just do this and share your experiences, how you felt, because that will be helpful for me as well, like how it is helping you guys. And if you are not feeling the same way I dictated here, so I will help you out like where you basically lacked. And the other thing is, those people who are not having crystals, they should not worry about it, because the main thing is intentions. We use crystals to, you know, enhance the properties. We use crystals to enhance the things which we are doing, to enhance the, you know, magical activities which we are doing. So if you don't have crystals and if you don't afford to buy crystals, then it's fine. Don't feel that these, like your salt will not be blessed enough and you won't be able to perform the magic. It is not like that. But yes, if you can have crystals and if you are already having it, so just cleanse your crystal before doing that and place it, as I said, so it will really give you good results. And those people who are having moldavite with them while doing this process, if they will hold moldavite in their hand, trust me, you will feel that all the energies around you, the gods, goddesses you invited, all the, you know, angels you invited around you, you can feel them actually, that they are blessing your soul. Because moldavite is gold, god's stone, so it is not a crystal basically. So it is some like meteoroid which dropped from the sky. So this is really good while you are communicating with different, you know, different energies around you. So do this if you have these stuffs. If you don't have anything, then also it's fine. Your intentions matters. Do this with a fresh mind and this will help you. Okay, so keep watching and stay tuned with our YouTube channel. Whenever I will upload some videos, you will get notified if you will subscribe to our channel, and keep the notifications on. So don't forget to do that and wait for my next video. Thank you.